Hello and welcome back everyone. Today in this video, I am going to show you the endless fluid simulation that I made in Blender. Here you can see the lava is flowing down and the boxes are moving. So how to do this? Let's get along with it and see the whole process in under 5 minutes. Starting with a basic box, which I will inset and extrude inside to make it hollow. Our fluid will, as you saw in the first part, go inside this box. I'm adding an icosphere, so the fluid is also distributed properly and there is a effect which is visible. And after doing that, I'm adding array modifier, so I don't have to duplicate the objects again and again. Here you can see I've added this physics setting. In the fluid section, I went inside the effector. So this object is able to interact with the fluid that will flow in the container. Also, I'm adding another cube. This cube, as you can see, will contain this quick effect of fluid. Just go to objects and quick effects. Inside that, quick fluid. Here you can see there is already a sort of fluid inside. This is the default one. We will be changing this and rebaking the whole mesh. So I'm resizing it so it's correct to the dimensions of the box. And after placing it in this position, I will edit this. Here you can see always click this mesh option. If you don't click this, your mesh will not respond to the fluid. This is very important. And after doing this and baking it, you can see the fluid is responding to the box that I made. If I go to the solid view after this, you can have a solid look at this. And the flow looks good. So for the next part, we need to animate the keyframes. So what my plan is, actually the dimension of my box was 2 units and the distance between the two boxes is also 2 units. So I'm putting the distance in x direction 4 units. So in this keyframe, you can see in this animation, the object moves 4 units forward. So the next box comes to its place. So I can move this a little bit ahead so that effect is much more faster. But I realize there is a big issue that I'm facing. See, the fluid is baked, and if the frames move forward, see what happens. The fluid is not moving forward. So there are multiple solutions to this, but I would recommend to use this simple solution. You can animate and move the whole domain ahead in the same way the boxes are moving. I found this best. You can also bake the mesh according to it for the fluid, but I found it much more resource consuming. So it's best idea to move the whole domain, and you can see the output now. And it's very good. It's working. Fantastic. For the next part, let's add materials to our fluid. I'm using simple colors, but the idea is that the fluid is visible outside the box. So box will be transparent and the fluid will be glowing fluid like a lava. So here I'm using the emission property and increasing its value. You can see it's reflecting, but the box, although its transparency is more, is not totally transparent because we need to enable this checkbox, screen space refractions. And you can see it's visible now. So after this, it's totally up to your creativity, how you want to make it. So according to my camera angle, I added elements and just a floor in the bottom part, so it looks like it's not an empty place and it's an endless going conveyor belt. Although it's one video, you can see it's going on and on. It's a perfect loop. Try to make it. And once more, thank you very much for watching and stay tuned for more. Bye bye.